Good morning, dear students. In the last class, we have discussed about the pitcher plants. Okay, the pitcher plants are catching the insects, and they will absorb from the insects. They will absorb the nutrients from the insects. Okay. So today I am going to discuss about the saprotrophs. What is the saprotrophs? Here, saprotrophs. In the last class, we are discussing about the insectivorous plants. Okay, insectivorous plants means nutrients they are absorbed from the insect. Insect eating plants are called insectivorous plants. Okay, insect eating plants. For example, pitcher plant. Pitcher plant is a insectivorous plant. Okay. Now saprotrophs. What is the saprotrophs? Sometimes you might have seen packets of mushrooms sold in the vegetable market. You have an idea on about the mushrooms? In the vegetable market, sometimes we can observe the mushrooms. Okay. You may have also seen fluffy umbrella like patches growing in moisture soils or on rotting wood during the rainy season. Okay, in the rainy season, once you have to observe in the agriculture field soil, sometimes they will growing the umbrella like patches. Okay, fluffy umbrella like patches growing on the moisture soils or on rotting wood during the rainy season. Let us find out the what type of nutrients they need to survive and from where they get. Here in the agriculture field, sometimes in the vegetable market also, we can observe the mushrooms. You might have observed, you might have seen packets of mushrooms mushrooms sold in the vegetable market. Sold in the vegetable market. Vegetable market. Okay. You may have also seen fluffy umbrella like patches growing in moisture soils or on rotting wood during the rainy season. Okay, during the rainy season, we have also seen fluffy umbrella like patches. The shape is umbrella like patches growing in moisture soil, growing in moisture soils on rotting wood, on rotting wood during the rainy season. Rainy season. Let us find out what type of nutrients they need to survive and from where they get them. Okay, so already we are discussed for the plants and some other also, they need the nutrients for growing, the maintain the good health. They require the proteins and minerals and some other things also. Okay, in the proteins, carbohydrates and minerals also they are required, and along with water. So these and all they are taking from the soil, but some of the plants are they are taking from the insects, they are taking from the other plant. If they are taking the nutrients from the other plants, means we can call the parasites. And for suppose some of the plants are, they are absorbing the nutrients from the insects. That is called insectivorous plants. Okay, let us find out what type of nutrients they need to survive and from where they get them. Okay, by the activity we have to understand how they take the nutrients and how they are surviving. We can discuss in the activity. Okay, so what is the activity? In this activity we have to discuss about the mushrooms. First we have to take a piece of bread and moisten it with water. First we have to take the a piece of bread. Okay, bread pieces is there na in your home. You have to take the a piece of bread and moisten in the in it with water. We can moisten with water. After that leave it in a moisture warm place for 2-3 days or until fluffy patches appears on them. First we have to take the one piece of bread and we can moisten it in with water. After that leave it in moisture warm place for 2-3 days or until fluffy patches appears on them. Okay, what is the color of these patches? Observe the patches under a microscope or a magnifying glass. Okay, in the what is the use of microscope and magnifying glass? That is clearly visible. We have to clearly visible for small things. For suppose virus, bacteria, that is a very small things. How can we observe? By the naked eye we can't see the bacteria and viruses. By the help of microscope only we have to observe very small things. Which are the small things we can observe by the microscope only? For example virus, bacteria and small things. Which are the small things is there? We can observe by the microscope only. Under microscope it will be visible clearly. In normal naked eye we can't see the small things. So that is the use of microscope. Okay, microscope or a magnifying glass. Magnifying glass also it will be visible clearly. Now write down your observation in your notebook. You will see cotton like threads spread on the piece of bread. Okay, this is the activity. In this activity the organisms are called fungi. Okay, after the 2-3 days what will happen when we are observing on the bread? We can see the cotton like threads spread on the piece of bread. Cotton like threads will be grow on the after 2-3 days on the bread piece. Okay, these organisms are called fungi. That like cotton cotton threads like is there na, that is called fungi. Okay, they have a different mode of nutrition. They absorb the nutrition from the bread. Now activity, in the activity what we have to do? Take a piece of bread. Take a piece of bread and moisten it with water. With water. And after that we can leave it in moist warm place for 2-3 days. For 2-3 days or until fluffy patches appears on them. Fluffy patches appear on them. Okay, so we can take a piece of bread and moisten it with water. Leave it in a moisture warm place for 2-3 days. After that we have to leave that bread until fluffy patches appears on them. Okay, I will send the diagram, mushroom diagrams. Okay, you have to observe. After the class I will send the diagram also. Okay, so what is the color of these patches? What is the color of patches? How can we observe that color of patches and you that patches? By the observe the patches under the microscope. Observe the patches. Observe the patches under a microscope. Under a microscope. Under a microscope or a magnifying glass. Magnifying glass. Okay, we can observe by the that patches after 2-3 days they are on the bread pieces growing the patches, fluffy patches. We can observe by the microscope or magnifying glass. Write down your observation in the notebook. You will see cotton like thread spread on the piece of bread. Okay, you will see, you will find out, you will see cotton like threads spread on the piece of bread, spread on the piece of bread. Okay, you will see cotton like threads spread on the piece of bread. Okay, after 2-3 days we can observe the cotton like threads on the piece of bread. These organisms are called fungi. What is a fungi? These organisms, okay, like cotton threads, organisms are called fungi. These organisms are called, these organisms are called fungi. These organisms are called fungi. They have a different mode of nutrition. They absorb the nutrients from the bread. From the bread they are absorbing the nutrients. How it is possible? Actually, generally plants are or other things are absorbed from the soil only, but here they are absorbing the nutrients from the bread. These organisms are called fungi. They have a different mode of nutrition. They absorb the nutrition from the bread. They absorb the nutrients from the bread. They absorb the nutrients from the bread. Bread. Okay. This mode of nutrition in which organisms take in nutrients from dead and decaying matter is called saprotrophic nutrition. What is the saprotrophs? And the saprotrophic nutrition means they are absorbing the nutrients from the dead organisms. Which organisms take the nutrients from the dead and decaying matter? They are absorbing the bread is a dead and decaying matter. So they are absorbing from the bread. So that is called saprotrophic nutrition. The type of nutrition is called saprotrophic nutrition. Now, this mode of nutrition in which organisms take in nutrition, this mode of nutrition, this mode of nutrition, this mode of nutrition in which organisms, in which organisms take the, in which organisms take the, in which organisms take the, take in nutrients, take in nutrients, nutrients from dead and decaying, dead and decaying matter, dead and decaying matter is called, what we can call, saprotrophic. Saprotrophic न्यूट्रिशन, सॉप्रोट्रोपिक न्यूट्रिशन. ओके, व्हाट इज द सॉप्रोट्रोपिक न्यूट्रिशन? जनरल दे आर ऑब्जर्विंग द न्यूट्रिएंट्स फ्रॉम द डेड एंड डिकेइंग मैटर. That is called, which organisms are taking nutrition from dead and decaying matter is called saprotropic nutrients. Okay. So mushrooms are absorbing the fungi are absorbing the nutrients from the dead and decay matter. So that is called saprotropic nutrition. This type of nutrition is called saprotropic nutrition. And such organisms with saprotropic mode of nutrition are called saprotrophs. Such organisms with a saprotropic mode of nutrition, which organisms through the saprotropic mode nutrition, that type of organisms are called saprotrophs. Such organisms with saprotropic mode of nutrition mode of nutrients. Okay, that organisms of saprotropic mode of nutrition are called what we can call are called saprotrophs. Saprotrophs. Simply here, what is the saprotropic nutrition and the saprotrophs? Which organisms are they are surviving with saprotropic mode of nutrition are called, that organisms are called saprotrophs. What is the saprotropic nutrition? Which organisms are take the nutrients from the dead and decaying matter is called saprotropic nutrition. Okay, which organisms they are absorbing the nutrients from the dead and decaying matter, that is called saprotropic nutrition. These organisms are called, this type of organisms, these organisms are called saprotrophs. Okay, and fungi also grow on pickles, leather cloths and other articles that are left in hot and humid weather for a long time. Okay, once you have to observe during in the rainy season, they spoil many things. Ask your parents and about the means of fungi in your house. The fungal spores are generally present in the air. Okay, fungi also grow on pickles in your home. Once you have to observe long term, very long time, if we leave the pickles, means on the pickles fungi slowly it will be grow on the pickles. Pickles, leather cloths and other articles that are left in hot and humid weather, okay, fungi also grow on pickles, leather cloths and other articles that are left in hot and humid weather for a long time during the rainy season they spoil many things. Okay, the fungal spores are generally present in the air. The fungal spores are generally present in air. Present in air. And when they land on wet and warm things, what happen? They germinate and grow. Now can you figure out how we can protect our things from getting spoiled? Okay, see here, fungi also grow on pickles, leather cloths and other articles that are left in hot and humid weather for a long time. We have to left in hot and humid weather. What will happen? Fungi also grow on pickles, leather cloths and other articles. During the rainy season, we have to observe the fungi more. In your home also, you have to observe. Now this is a rainy season. This time, that fungi is growing very more. In outside also, in inside home also. Okay? They spoil many things. That fungi spoil many things. The fungal spores are generally present in air. Actually, that fungal spores are generally present in the air. When they land on wet and warm things, they germinate and growing on the surface of the that material. For suppose if they are land on the any bread or something, any other material means pickles, any other cloth also, walls also. Sometimes you have to observe in the walls of surface of the walls also. Okay, it will be in the rainy season, it will be get the fungus. Okay, this is about the saprotrophs. Okay, this is about the saprotrophs. Remaining we have to discuss in the next class. Thank you.